Some of the angle types that we run into when we're talking about angles, we have acute angles, refers to an angle, a smaller type of angle. It's one that's between 0 and 90 degrees. We have a right angle. A right angle is one that equals exactly 90 degrees. An obtuse angle is one that's bigger than 90 degrees, so between 90 and 180. And then a straight angle is 180 degrees. And really, a straight angle is just a line, okay, or a line segment or something like that. All right. So anytime we have a line segment that has angles coming off of it, well, we know that that whole angle is 180 degrees. If I have a line, it's a straight angle, it's 180 degrees, okay? So acute, 0 to 90. Right is when we get to 90. Obtuse is 90 to 180. And straight is 180 degrees, okay? For example, if I look at these guys, I want to draw some of these angles this time. And again, using my protractor, just kind of in reverse here, what I would do is I just put my protractor down. And from there, I put a point. So I put a little dot right at that starting value. And then I just choose one of these lines. And let's say you wanted to use the outside track. If I use the outside track, I would start with a line that's at zero there. So I start with a line that's zero using the outside track. And if I want to go 35 degrees, I just count on the outside track and say, okay, 35 degrees is right here. So I put a little point. And then I draw a line using a straight edge to kind of connect that. Okay? And that's it. So I work backwards. I start at that. So I give myself a point to start at. I mark the zero and I count to 35. Okay? Likewise, if I scoot this guy over a little bit. Grab this thing and scoot it over. Let's say I wanted to do 90 degrees. Let's use the inside track this time, okay? And see, this will allow me to save a little space too. So if I put a point right here, if I want to use the inside track, I start with this thing at zero. So I draw a line at zero. And for the inside track, zero goes to the right like that. And then I count on the inside track. I say, okay, let's count on the inside track. I'm counting along here until I get to 90. And I just put a point right at 90. And I draw a line, or array rather. Okay? And so now I have a 90 degree angle. Okay? The next one asks me to draw a 145 degree angle. Let me space this thing out a little bit more. Once again, I can use the inside or the outside track. I'll use the outside track this time. Why not? So I start here at the zero. So here's my zero is right here. So that's for the outside track. I draw a line that way. That gives me zero. And then I count to 145. So I count along the outside here till I get to 145 degrees and I mark it. Now I draw a line to that point or array to that point. Okay. There it is. And the last one, a straight angle. Let me come down here. If I want to draw a straight angle on this one, I start right here. I'll count the inside track this time. So here's zero. And if I count the inside track the whole way around to 180 degrees, it drops me off right here. And there it is. And of course, it's a line, and I could have just drawn a line. And so instead of using the protractor on that one, I could have easily just drawn a line to represent this thing because I know that 180 degrees is a straight angle. So it gives me a little bit of a shortcut built in there. Okay. The last thing that I might do here is this right angle, I might label with a little box. That symbol means that I have a right angle. So anytime we see that symbol, it's like telling me that it's a 90-degree angle without actually showing me the measurement, okay? And you should have seen it up here as well. There it is, okay? So that symbol, that box automatically means 90 degrees, automatically means a right angle, okay? And so I can say that without even using the words, without even using numbers, I can tell you what kind of angle that is, okay?